Call now with your question. 888-318-7884. This is Catholic Answers Live.
Welcome back to the show. Still joined by writer and editor Joseph Pearce. We're talking about finding God in literature. Before we go to the calls, I'll bring up another name of which you're very familiar and whose writings you've studied for many years, William Shakespeare.
Yes, indeed.
Shakespeare's Catholicism is another one of those hidden gems that once you're told about it, you suddenly have a new set of lenses through which to read his plays. What was it like to discover his Catholic faith as present in his stories, in the premises he worked with?
Well, it was actually a challenge to me because I remember having discussions with my colleagues at Ave Maria when I first came to the States. And one of them in particular believed that Shakespeare was a Catholic, and I didn't believe him. Hmm. I said, there's not sufficient evidence to hold that position. We have to be agnostic in the broader sense of that word,
right.
Which we just don't know. Bit by bit, it's like a piece of a jigsaw puzzle. You notice one fact, another fact, and there's a threshold beyond which you begin to realize, hold on, there's something to this. Mm-hmm. And I started to study it then systematically, and the pieces came together. And of course, we don't have the whole puzzle. But if you've got a landscape and you've got 60% of the pieces, you know what the landscape is, even if you haven't got all the detail. And that's where we're at with Shakespeare. And of course, knowing that Shakespeare's Catholic forces us to look at the plays through Shakespeare's own Catholic eyes. And when we do that, whole new dimensions of Catholicism come to light.
How persecuted were Catholics when? Coterminous with Shakespeare's life?
Oh, very much persecuted, to the extent that many Catholics were put to their death for their Catholicism. Shakespeare, the evidence shows strongly, knew at least two Catholic priests that were put to their death, possibly three, and two of whom have been canonized by the Church.
Is the evidence that you adduce internal to his work, or is there biographers at the time or evidence outside his actual plays?
Both. I mean, my first book on Shakespeare was looking at the biographical evidence, purely the documentary evidence from his life, court cases, property deeds, last wills and testaments, etc. And then the next two books I wrote were looking at the evidence to be found in the plays and the poems.
Mm-hmm. I don't suppose he'd have a house with a bright neon sign saying Catholic lives here. It makes sense that his identity as a Catholic would have been kept
exactly
under wraps.
Although he did buy a house that was known to be a hotbed, a center for Catholic activity,
like a safe house.
It was literally with secret passageways down to the river. He actually bought that house, and it continued to be used as a center for Catholic activity after he purchased it. So there's evidence of him taking an active role.
On Friday, I'm interviewing a very talented, above my level, believe me, Angelo Stagnaro. He's the president of the Catholic Magicians Guild, and he's sort of a historian on magical apparatus and one of the greatest designers of magic tricks. I forget his name now. I think he's either blessed or a saint. Is from that era, and the equipment that was later used on stage originally was designed to hide people, i.e., Catholics from their persecutors.
Right, yeah.
So
priesthoods.
Yeah.